Hello and welcome to another audio analysis. In today's video, we're taking a look at the track Music on the Radio by the Australian electronic duo Empire of the Sun. This is the latest track to be released from their upcoming fourth studio album titled Ask That God, which is due to be released on the 26th of July of this year. We've already got to hear the previous track in the form of Changes, which really did see the band making a return after 8 years away, with them releasing their latest album, Two Vines, in 2016. And we got to see more of what we typically do see from the band, a very uplifting style, very sonically pleasing and very laid back, but also saw them adapting to the changes within the world and showing that in their music as well, continue to show that they were accepting that things have to change and things have to move on. So will this latest track be like music to our ears or simply dulcet tones? Let's take a look at exactly how it sounds. So already with this song, we can see the duo continues to do what they do best, provide this hypnotic, very pleasing and sonically cleansing sound that they do bring across. It is very hypnotic and almost therapeutic. It's like musical therapy at times, how we see elements of funk, a little bit of disco, a bit of lo-fi as well, all just melded around this very soft bass line and the very uplifting vocals that we do see coming across from Luke Steele as well, to really provide this very pleasant and atmospheric sound. You can almost see things like Daft Punk and the influences they maybe draw from them as well in lots of the sounds that they do bring across. But with this album, they're really building into this idea of change coming through and how things are constantly adapting. And for the duo, they're moving into a new era and adapting to this new change, not only in the world but also musically as well. And we can see that certainly, especially in the chorus. I don't like the music on the radio, they don't play my song. I don't like the music on the radio, but I sing along. So whilst they're not typically playing on the radio, the sorts of things that they are influenced by, or even their own music, hasn't always been kind of hugely successful, apart from some of the songs from that first album they did release. They kind of just still accept the music that is on the radio today, because sound has changed very much in terms of what's popular, and we've seen that evolve over time. We've seen lots of different genres really be very prevalent in the actual charts and kind of find that success. But especially with the rise of streaming and stuff, we've got to the point where we have seen a lot of charts really be dominated by a lot of solo artists who could just fire out singles left, right and centre and kind of dominate. Just look at things like Taylor Swift, who effectively, if it wasn't for certain rules that they put in place, would have maybe 19 of the top 20 in a chart. So you can kind of see that idea coming across. But I do like the way they're reflecting on the idea of, even though they don't like a lot of the music that's now on the radio, they still sing along. And I kind of really resonate with this. I find myself doing that. If I've got the radio on, a lot of stuff sounds the same to me, but I still just kind of find myself bobbing along to it and just getting sucked into it. So it's really got those hooks that really drag you in. So I also like the way they're actually exploring maybe some some of the influences on them as a duo. Nerd, Tangerine Dream, Spaceman could be a reference to something such as Elton John. Blame It on Dexy could be Dex's Midnight Runners with songs such as Come On Eileen. A lot of these artists that certainly didn't find a heavy success in terms of the charts, but certainly were very influential in the impact they had on a lot of other artists and how a lot of people grew up listening to. They were very much more underground, but really had a lot of influence in other people. And we can see that continued. The idea of Neon Trees, Ladytron as well, also being brought in through lots of this. So they're kind of blaming it on the fact they maybe didn't find success because they've been inspired by artists that have that very much that creative flair that didn't resonate with kind of a lot of people, or lead to mainstream radio success, but still were very unique in their own right. I mean, it's something the duo have really done quite heavily over the years, is really show that identity and that expressionism through their music videos as well as their music themselves, in being a duo that are very unique in their sound and don't kind of give in to the status quo to kind of just really try and reach out to kind of get these chart-topping hits. They want to produce something that means something to them. Yeah, certainly another very quirky track coming from the duo, but great to see them adding up to another song that they have provided us with, and really just showing again more of these ideas of how they're kind of changing. We've certainly seen that with the music videos as well, them transitioning to different areas for the first two with Changes and now this one, maybe moving between different cultures, different settings and environments. The first one kind of had much more of a day beach focus. This is more nightclub kind of karaoke going on. So really just showing the idea of how things change over time and adapting to different environments. And one thing I really think comes through quite strongly on this track is the idea of not losing that sense of kind of uniqueness within yourself, really showing they're still pushing out what they feel is right for them and just whatever speaks to them, even though in some elements of this track they kind of gave in effectively to some of the typical tropes we do see in a lot of popular music. I mean, electronic music naturally tends to be a little bit more repetitive, but we could see that with most of the lyrics being very set in stone on this song, very repetitive. There wasn't kind of a lot of variation or a lot of depth to it, so it could be them kind of poking a bit of fun at the kind of music that's on the radio by kind of adapting to that, but musically sticking to what they do best and really just continue to provide that very uplifting, upbeat vibe. And it's really difficult to kind of feel sad when you listen to an Empire of the Sun track, because it just naturally has this beautiful aurora to it that really comes across and just really just kind of has that natural bop that really just you kind of get dragged into, and you really just kind of almost ride these waves of hypnotism with a lot of their music. So great to see them maybe referencing back to some of the influences and the inspiration behind the way that their music has evolved over time, and kind of making a little bit of a snide remark at kind of a lot of the music on the radio today, that accepting that whilst they don't like it, they kind of sing along to it and they just kind of accept it that's popular because it's what a lot of people enjoy, but just kind of accepting that they're glad they're still doing things in their own unique way. So there we have it, the latest offering from Empire of the Sun, but I don't think it'll be quite making its way to plenty of radio stations, unfortunately. I know here in the UK, the only songs you ever really tend to hear of theirs is Walking on a Dream or We Are the People. Unfortunately, a lot of the newer ones don't really tend to see as much play, but great to see them still continue to do what they do best and starting to put out more music. I'm going to be really interested to see how they continue to add more tracks to this upcoming album, to see whether it will continually revolve around the idea of change, but these first two tracks certainly do give off that impression. But I would love to know your thoughts about this track in the comments section below. Are you glad to see them sticking with their very unique sound and continuing to evolve and add new things in? Or do you kind of feel like these newer songs are lacking a little bit compared to their previous material? I really would love to know your thoughts. Also, if you would like to see more Empire of the Sun content, I did cover the previous track, Changes, in a separate video, which you can find the link to in the description of this one. And if you'd like to see more content like this overall, then please do feel free to subscribe. And I will see you in the next Dodger Analysis.